I really think that you need to ask yourself one simple question. How do you feel about frontal male nudity?
I like to wake up in the morning and listen to my favorite show. I like to wake up in the morning and turn on my radio.
Psychosomatic auditory hallucinations.
The Morning Buzz with Mojo, Lee Scott, and Spanish on 100.5 The Buzz.
Live from Studio E inside the Sunshine Broadcast Center, this is The Morning Buzz. Mojo, Lee Scott, and Spanish. Up at 313-310-0 1-888-940-1005. Welcome to the show this morning, Lee Scott.
Yo,
what's happening?
What's going on? Oh, I'm still so tired. Way too late working on that project last night.
That unpolitically correct Indian project you were working on?
Yeah, my son's Indian project. I made him, he's asking his teacher this morning, are they going to have Colored People History Month in February? Because of the...
colored people?
His teacher sent home this Indian project. I was like, isn't it Native Americans? Isn't this, shouldn't we... I mean, like, what Indian is it? Is it the ones that live next door to Pakistan? It's not even accurate, let alone not politically correct.
Did he say is it the 7-Eleven Indians? Or is it the Indians that raped and pillaged and gave him casino Indians?
Dot's not feathers.
Way to say it now. Yeah.
he had such an issue with it. Like, last night my phone rings at, like, 9:30, and he's like, dude, what do you think about this? He's all serious on the other end of the phone, and I'm like, what do you mean? What do I think about what? And he's like, well, my son brought home this project. And I'm like, this is not the direction I thought this conversation was going in. It was like, I thought he was going to be like, I have hepatitis. Yeah. Do you have a good doctor or something like that? But no.
That's coming later. Conversation we have to have. We'll talk about that after the show.
Wait a minute. You're going to help him. You're into helping him with like a genetic, a sexual disease. I'm with you, baby.
Yeah.
But how?
Son's project.
Son. Hey,
I didn't have time for that other jazz.
Good for you.
No, I didn't have any time for
you.
That.
I'm with you down there.
The one thing would intrigued me a lot more because there would have been a backstory about how I got it. The other story ended with basically just sitting there and going, why is this an issue?
Hepatitis blankets, yay. Smallpox blankets, nay.
Anything with bumps.
Right.
Yay.
Whatever.
We have guests in the studio. I guess we should go ahead and introduce them. Go ahead, Lee Scott.
We got Robert Kelly and Jay Davis here with us, which is awesome. They just did Tourgasm with Dane Cook, but they've been, if you guys follow comedy like I do, these guys have been around for a while and have been doing it, and we're really happy to have them in Gainesville this evening. Thanks, guys.
Yeah, it's great to be here, man. Thanks.
It's your first time in Gainesville?
No, actually, my sister went to Santa Fe Community College.
Yes!
Yeah. He's got ties to everybody in this building in some way or another. I'm like, no.
Yeah.
I thought you were just being hospitable, but
no. He's like, I know you.
Good work.
I was an intern here. Yeah.
Friends of mine went to University of Florida, and some that weren't so smart went to Santa Fe.
Speaking
to
the mic,
my sister.
Speaking of the mic. Pretend that he loves you.
Hi.
Yeah, speaking of the mic, the way you got this gig.
Casting couch.
But no, it's great to be in Gainesville. We're excited. We're doing the show at the venue tonight. The doors are at 8, and the show's at 9 o'clock, 18 and up. So come out and watch Robert Kelly and I on stage.
We need to stress the 18 and up ladies.
Yes.
Actually, if you're 18 and up and you're a man, you can't come. No, I'm joking. 18 and up all the way, baby.
It's a ladies only show.
Imagine that. How great would that be for Jay?
For you guys.
For a dumpy ass like me. It'd be, you agree, Jay, and I'd get you too.
Well, you hurt your leg not that long ago, right? So you just pull out the injury again and
you're
get
right.
The sympathy women.
I smacked my ACL and then I quit
smoking.
How
are you doing with that?
It's still, I almost bent in half in the other room.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, it's. I gotta get it fixed. I have my gay trainer, Bill. What's wrong with that? I'm a man.
You have to keep telling. Yeah, Robert has to keep telling himself that. I'm a man, Bill. Bill, I'm a man.
I really hope. I wish he really. When he's stretching me out at the end, and I wish he would wear underwear. Yeah, I just, you know, I don't like to feel the Plato play day on the back of my neck. Apparently, you're awake this morning, Bill. So I'm working on my knee. It's getting a little better. I snatch it on Torgasm, but it's getting better.
I still think that you should pull the injury out to get chicks if you have to.
I don't think he has to do that. Not in a college town. I mean, think about the ugly dudes that are in bands.
Yeah, but
that
what
get
if he's at a marginal woman where he's like in the middle
stage,
where he's teetering?
You're fine. You're good here.
I hear you. And it's actually the only thing I could pull out is my knee injury. I couldn't pull anything else out and impress women. So thank you. Thank you for thank you. thank you. Around the morning.
Singer. Hey, it's the morning flake.
It's the morning zoo. Yeah. Thank you. Robert Kelly's in town. He just made a penis joke.
Awesome.
Yeah, you're right, man. I should take. I'm going to take the knee out tonight. I'm going to wear the brace on the outside. Yeah, I'm going to do that, and I'm going to slice my cheek.
Now, you guys are touring all over the place, so I'm sure that after the shows, you guys can. Do you find people are starting to throw bras on stage? You got the whole ladies thing going on. I mean, do you still have to use MySpace like pervs like we do?
Yes.
Yeah. MySpace is awesome.
Yes, I'm on MySpace. I tried to get 9 girls on a cam last night.
You, Robert,
7 hours, and I didn't get any of them.
Robert, apparently, you're going with the tall guys work on MySpace because you apparently you're 7'8" bodybuilder on MySpace.
Yeah.
And you're a Caucasian Libra.
Isn't it obvious when he walked in here?
And his occupation, I make pee-pee their pants.
Yeah.
Isn't that what we all
want
to do?
Yes. I want pee-pee in the pants.
Yeah.
Dude, I lied.
You know your job worked.
I lied on my MySpace and my J date. I'm not even Jewish.
Speaking of Jewish, poor Jay, you look like an old Jewish lady on your MySpace. On your,
what is that?
What? This photo was taken from like 2030. This is it now. They did that like advancing where they show what you look like 30 years from now. What the hell happened?
I don't know.
Did you smoke like 3 packs of cigarettes?
It's like Emilio Estevez and Anne Hesh morphed into one. I don't know.
Basically what happened.
Jay has his own morning show.
That's good work though.
I know. I pulled up his website and I was like, that's not Jay. Jay's like a young guy. This is
it's like the FBI got
like that
a hold
guy
of this.
From Law and Order.
Jay's gonna have his own morning show competing with The View. It's called Ellen.
I do look like Ellen.
You do, Jay.
Ellen eyes.
You look a little chapped in this photo.
Comes out dancing before.
Now, come on, how many times did it take to get this picture though? I mean, you guys are never this serious.
I mean,
you seriously look like
taking that
you
picture.
Might run a library or something.
I look like I'm doing a lie detector test and I got caught in a lie.
He's like, oh, seriously.
You know, this is when you die, Jay, and I don't want to talk about that. I hope it's a long time from now. But when you die, you know this is the photo they're going to run of you, right? It's never the good photo. It's the one where you were like,
how did you
like when Nick Nolte dies, it's going to be.
Yeah, it's going to be the mugshot.
It's going to be the mugshot, you know?
With the puke in there.
I'll tell you what happened. It's called genetics.
I feel like there should be like a cartoon bubble that says like, oy vey. Flavin, nice lady.
Wait, I don't like the fact that he just switched over to mine. Did you have a headshot of me?
No, I didn't. All right, didn't. Go. Oh, well, yeah. We've got you from apparently 1983 when you were on Saved by the Bell.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't. It was 18 Slater.
You guys didn't even go to my...
pre-goatee.
Can I just say that you didn't even have enough sense? You guys are so lazy. You just took the first photo off the internet. There's actually a page that has photos. It says photos, but you're so stupid and lazy that you say, you know what? Just drag that.
Yeah.
You clicked an icon.
It clicked. You know, like the stuff that's on the side of Google?
You know,
it's like, buy Robert Kelly tapes here out of the trunk of my
car.
That's
not even me.
That's where I got the photo from.
That guy whittles wood things. That's the other Robert Kelly.
I swear this is A.C. Slater. That's not you. It's Mario Lopez.
Mario Lopez. I'm changing my name. Tonight on the show at the venue at 9 o'clock, Mario Lopez and Jay Davis and Anne Hesh.
Ellen's eyes will be there. Ellen's eyes.
There's going to be a very metrosexual looking dude going up front. And then a fat, chunky bastard who lost everything last night in a hotel room.
Really?
Yeah, I did. I lost everything. Self-esteem. Confidence.
His pants. His wallet.
Oh my god.
Confidence. I've been looking for my confidence for 2 hours.
MySpace really makes you feel good for around 3.5 hours.
Oh, it does.
And then you realize, you know what, I am a loser. Yeah. And then you go right back into MySpace. Do I have any new comments? Yes.
All it is 13th grade.
Ah, dude, let me tell you something. How great it is, though. This is the funny part when you get a sexy eye and you get all excited because it's just an eye.
Right.
And it's sexy, and you're going to click on it, and maybe you might luck out, and it's a hot chick with naked photos on her MySpace. Or it could be some chick who works at the zoo.
Or lives at the zoo, for that matter.
Thank you for helping me with that. I have a pretty eye.
It's just one.
Just one eye. I get suspicious of people who use
it's
body
true.
Parts.
I mean, and what about all the glamour shots? You know, you see girls are taking pictures from the side now. You know, well, you know not to trust them, you know?
Oh, yeah. It's good from far, but far from good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen some of these, like, people. You actually meet some of these people, and you see them, and you're like, that's why you took a headshot. You know what I'm saying? Because like anything below the head was just out of control.
The only thing that sucks is that I'm one of those people. I'm one of those people. I have a great...
Do you
know how many people are disappointed when they show up at my shows?
Hey, listen, I go by Totally Hot Lee Scott on the air. Do you know how disappointed people are when they see me? Because I'm not good looking enough for it to be
true.
Like,
I totally
know
how disappointed.
I'm not ugly enough for it to be ironic.
I'm disappointed right now. You just made me disappointed.
Yeah, it is.
I actually think you're actually hot. It's kind of hot. Not to be gay.
Appreciate it.
Yeah, in a very
Scooby-Doo
type of way.
I'll be introducing you later, so that's not... Like, here's Robert Kelly. He said I was hot. Give it up.
And then the show goes downhill.
Wah, wah, wah.
Because I walk out and they're like, wait a minute. Yeah, I'm a big fan
it
of
it. It goes downhill when they start picturing you two having sex is when it starts going
are you
downhill.
Gonna, wow, that was going in a way that I didn't really want it. We tried to find the humor. We didn't, and you made it real. Thanks. Thanks, second stepdad that came in late at night.
Hey, I just wanted to put that in your head to let it run around the rest of the day.
Are you...